Hey, what's up, YouTube? Welcome to my podcast. My name is Matteo Venieri, and this is the MVP show. I decided to start my channel by doing a series of videos on the NFL. I went through every single offseason move of all 32 teams. I took a look at their schedules, and I tried to predict their record at the end of the season. These are all my opinions. I'm not trying to say these are facts. But if you want to discuss with me and tell me what you think, please leave a comment down below. Thank you. Today, I will talk about the AFC North and the Baltimore Ravens. So let's get to it. Rage on that beat, going crazy. Last season, the Baltimore Ravens were a juggernaut in their division, and I think this year they will repeat as divisional champions. What I like about what they did in the offseason is that they improved what their strength was, and now they're possibly the best defense in the league. What they did in the offseason, they signed Calais Campbell. They traded for him, just a fifth rounder, that was nothing. And they added Derek Wolfe from Denver. Last year, their D-line was good, but not great at pressuring the quarterback. And I think that the additions of Campbell and Wolfe will make their defense that much better in that department. Another key piece they added was during the draft. They drafted Patrick Queen from LSU. He's going to be the starting middle linebacker next season. And Lamar Jackson welcomed him on the team by calling him Ray Lewis Jr. Now, we'll see if that's a great prediction or an all-time cold take. Now, speaking of Lamar Jackson, of course, he had an MVP season last year. And although I believe that the first half of the season, Russell Wilson was the MVP, I cannot argue that throughout the whole season, Lamar Jackson finished stronger and had an overall better season. Having said all of that about their defense, now let's talk about Baltimore's offense. They bring back the same exact personnel with one notable exception. I'm talking about right guard Marshall Yanda, who retired in the offseason. Yanda is a future Hall of Famer and probably the best right guard of his generation. He is one of the reasons why Pro Football Focus ranked their O-line the second best last year. So even though I still think they're going to be excellent, there will be a slight decline in that department. Now, I briefly mentioned Lamar Jackson before, and there's one thing that, you know, one little piece of criticism that I'd like to move. Like I said, I like that the management chose to strengthen the defense, which was already really the primary reason why they went 14-2 last season. But I believe they should have done something on the offensive side of the ball, and specifically about the wide receivers. There's one stat that worries me a little bit. Last year, they only had one wide receiver with more than 340 yards. That cannot be enough. I do expect that this season, Hollywood Brown will improve, maybe even reach that 1,000 yards milestone, but there has to be more on that team, because I think teams will catch up a little bit more this season with the Ravens offense. And I think that when they have that 22 personnel, two running backs, two tight ends, they can become a little predictable once you understand exactly all the options that they have. And their plan B, well, I don't know exactly if they have one, if they can afford to rely on one wide receiver to beat their man and just dominate the game. Now let's look at their schedule. I think they have one massive advantage this year. The Ravens traveled just over 6,000 miles throughout the whole season. And believe me, during a global pandemic, this will be huge. Another thing is that they say that they have the easiest schedule. Now, this is based on the record. It's not really an opinion from last year. But I think that, you know, they start with Cleveland and Kansas City at home. I think they might split there. And if you look at the last month of the season, that's also relatively easy. They have Jacksonville, Giants, Cincinnati, and go to Cleveland. But that middle of the season, I don't think it's going to be easy, because besides you know, having Cincinnati at home, they go to Philly, they go to Indy, they go to Foxborough, they face Pittsburgh twice, as well as Tennessee and Dallas. Those are a whole lot of playoff teams, so I believe it's going to be challenging in that stretch. Now, overall, I have Baltimore going 12-4. I think they're going to win the division. I think that even though they're going to probably not be as dominant as they were last year, at the end of the day, the real challenge for the team is not during the regular season anymore. I think they proved they are a good regular season team, but this year, really, it's all about the postseason. Lamar Jackson is 0-2. He had a terrible first game. He had good numbers last season, but not really a good performance. And so I think that for the Ravens this year, it's all about winning not just one, but two playoff games, which would be the first time since they won the Super Bowl in 2013. Now, up next, the Pittsburgh Steelers.